Live from the north side of Chicago, Wrigley Field, we've got baseball on the show. The Atlanta Braves and the Chicago Cubs. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go. And on the hill in this one, Javier Assad.
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count, and to opposite guys be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
Fought off foul.
So glad these ballparks have installed the netting to protect the fans, keep things safer all around the league.
Swings and misses. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
3-1.
One down, base is empty. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
On the north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. Here's Austin Riley. Ground ball right side, could be two. Fired to second, on to Bush. It's a double play. One hit in the inning, but no one left. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. Back here at Wrigley Field, and on the mound now, Charlie Morton. What should we keep an eye on here?
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
Yeah, a foul ball. And now 2-2. Bounce that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Comes the 2-2. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Riley drifts towards it, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And there's one down. Time now for the Chicago Cubs lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
A wind and a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. One, two now. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Bellinger up to hit. Two down, nobody on. And it's fouled away. And the righty deals.
Ball. Two balls, two strikes.
Two outs, base is empty. should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And that's a two-bagger.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the ball straight to it. That's great work right there.
Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Christopher Morel. Man at second.
2-2.
In the dirt, blocked. Not in time. He's safe. And on the wild pitch, he goes down to third.
Strategy of winning a ball game when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
Here's the 2-2. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater. So nothing on the scoreboard through one. We're back on the show from Wrigley in a few. Back here at the friendly confines. Top of the second. And now Matt Olson up to hit. For Matt, a pretty impressive resume. A first round pick back in 2012. The Braves extended him 8 years, $168 million. Remember, they traded for him right at the end of the lockout in 2022. Middle of lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Low throw, and he can't pick it.
That was one of those swings that it feels like you're swinging an aluminum bat. It jumped off so hard, squared it up, and it went screaming at 108 miles per hour.
Here's Marcelo Zuna. And a pitch. Check swing, and that's a ball.
2-1.
Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Woody Keller making the calls behind home for us today.
And Boog, something to keep an eye on is how pitchers utilize the top part of the strike zone. We see a lot more of that in today's game with pitchers going up there with hard stuff. Keller, definitely an umpire that isn't afraid to call strikes up in that part of the strike zone.
Two two now. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And now Michael Harris. There's a strike at the knees. Man at first, one away. Righty to the plate. Pitch misses. And that's ball two. Wouldn't chase that time. And here it comes. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Kicks and fires. He goes down looking.
Oh, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
And now it's Travis d'Arnaud with the play. Two outs. comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Kicks and deals. Out of bounds, right side. Magical gathers and throws to first. And that is the inning. Braves strand one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Bottom half of inning number two. Now it's the veteran outfielder, Ian Happ. The 2-1. In the air, left side. Settles underneath it. Puts it away for the out.
Batting kick. The first baseman.
Michael Busch, the next cup to hit. The pitch. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. He's got it, and there's two away.
Batting seven. The second baseman. Nick.
Here's Nick Madrigal. Two down, nobody on.
2-1.
There's a swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
This to center field. Harris after it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. We'll move to the third with no score. Field, top half of the third inning. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Jared Kelnick. The 1-2. That's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Everything came together for him. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Here's Orlando Arcia. One one now. And another ball. Kelnick on at first, nobody out. And a foul ball. And a pitch. That one missed.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Amaya pulls that one down, and there's one away. And now it's Ronald Acuña Jr. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports, too. And it is 2-1. Here goes the runner. And he grounds one back up the middle, and it's through for a hit. The throw to third, he's in there.
Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. The timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it. There's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
So one out with two aboard. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. Two on, one out.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Top of the third, no score. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Drops into the glove, and there's two down.
Got the pitch that he wanted, just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open, backside collapsed a little bit, and the launch angle not where he needed it to be.
Now the third baseman, Austin Riley. Two on, two outs. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Pat makes the grab on the run. Two left for Atlanta, and we're still knotted at zero. As we go to the last of the third, now it's the right fielder, Mike Tauchman. The line of the pitch. That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. Just missed. And a pitch. The other way, and now maybe extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And he's got a leadoff double.
He was all over that one. That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left.
And now it's Miguel Amaya. Man at second. And now one and two.
1-2.
Just off the outside part of the plate.
It's a good take.
And that's off the inside edge. And a full countdown. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Gets him. One away on a drop third strike. No advance. Good job behind the dish.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Here's Nico Hoerner. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. The pitch. That's to third. Now a jump throw. Awesome play there.
The
My goodness, Chris. He had to generate a ton of power in that jump throw for the out. Let's take another look and dive into the numbers from StatCast.
Man, that's an impressive throw right there. In the air, all the way from third base. You've got to have a powerful arm to play third base, but he just showed he's got more than enough. He's got a cannon.
Now at the plate, Seiya Suzuki. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball three. Man on second, two down. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
The batter, the center fielder, Cody.
Here's Cody Bellinger. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Two outs.
Okay.
Christopher Morel up next. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Arcia whips it to first, and Bellinger is out. Inning over. Cubs strand a couple. Still no score. On to the fourth, and now it's Matt Olson's turn to hit.
Matt Olson.
One of the things that helped Olson in 2023, a stance adjustment, and that as well kept him more balanced for less swing and miss.
He's been pitching well, but we'll see what kind of adjustment the hitters make this second time through the order. We'll know if he's got really good stuff in this one or not.
What a win. And next for Atlanta, Marcelo Ozuna. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. Now he'll turn for second. Bellinger returns it to the infield, and now a runner moves into scoring position as we look for the first run of the ball game.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit. Now let's see if they can put up the first run of the game.
Here's the center fielder, Michael Harris. Man at second. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Fourth inning underway, no score. Ground ball right side. Steps on first for the out.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Travis Darno next up for the Braves. Ozuna on third with two out. Hard hit left side. In time to Bush. Third out. One left for Atlanta, and we are still scoreless. Bottom of the fourth, so now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Christopher Morel. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Kelnick makes the play. What a way.
Man, that's one of those at bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at bat.
The wind of the pitch. Ground ball to the right side. Into the outfield. Base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. Now, you're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Just one of those seen high base hits through the infield. It just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
And now the first baseman, Michael Busch. The 1-1.
Ball.
And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
The 2-1. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. All tied up. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
Two outs. And that's a little bit high. Outside, and it's 3-2. Mike Tauchman waiting to hit for the Cubs. Bounce to the right side, and it finds its way through for a hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Took to a board and two out. Scoreless game. And up next for Chicago, Mike Tauchman. Next offering is in for a strike.
1-2.
This one popped up, settles under it, makes the play, and it's out number three. Through four, still tied. Zip, zip. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top five, John Schaumbe with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Jared Kelnick. To kick the pitch.
No,
and that one
outside.
Just missed off the outside edge. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Hayden Wisniewski up and throwing for manager Craig Counsell. Brown also getting ready. Left-hand batter waits. Battling here as he fouls it away. Strikes and one out now.
It's almost like he's telling the guys in the bullpen, stand down. I got this.
Orlando Arcia next up for the Braves. One out, base is empty. Finds its way through, base hit.
Well, he's been working out of the stretch just about the entire game, Boo. A lot of base runners on against him, and he's just done a really nice job of scattering the hits, not giving up any runs. But at some point, your luck usually runs out.
Back to the top of the lineup, and here is Ronald Acuna Jr. Arcia at first, one gone. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. And that one upstairs. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Left field. Hap heads towards it. Hap snags it.
The batter number one. Second base. Ozzie Albies.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Righty delivers. That one fouled off. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
He's got a rare skill set out there on the mound. Even when he's low on energy, his stuff still has bite to it. You just don't see it flattening out just because he's tired. He's still delivering good action.
Two outs. That one missing inside.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
Here comes a 3-2. Stays alive. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. And we're at the top of the fifth. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. And that gets down into the gap around third. He will score, and they take the lead. 1-0.
Well, that worked out as good as it could have. We mentioned the RBI opportunity with the runner moving on the 3-2 pitch, and he cashed in by finding a hole in the outfield. You know, that takes a little extra concentration in the box because of the movement on the base pass. Easy to get distracted, so that was a really nice job there.
Here comes Craig Counsell, and we're going to see a pitching change. Javier Assad out of the game. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. On the mound now, Hayden Wesneski.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Man in scoring position with two away. Now in for the Braves, Austin Riley. And another ball.
Three balls, one strike.
Runner at second, two down. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Bellinger drifts towards it. And that is that. The Braves add one on the RBI double. It's now 1-0. Major League Baseball is on the show. And we're back. Now, here is Miguel Amaya.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Right-hander kicks deals. And another ball. The Braves bullpen has some activity. Jackson Stevens preparing to come on if needed. Lee, a lefty, warming up as well. Wouldn't chase that time.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff ball.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. And he deals. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. in the air to left center, sizing this one up. Makes the grab, one down.
Now batting, not shortstop.
Nico Horner, the next cup to hit. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power.
Here's a 1-1.
Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Out to short. Gets to it with a slide. In time. Got him.
We saw a few skills on display there for the out. Technique was great. Reaction time was there, and the slide was smooth. Watching that play come together was really fun.
Seiya Suzuki, the next cup to hit. Pitch misses there. Now two balls and a strike. The pitch. Ripped, but it curls foul. The wind and the pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Harris racing after it. Pulls it in on the run. And that is the third out of the inning. Top six. And now it's Atlanta's cleanup hitter, Matt Olson. Olson coming off an amazing 2023 campaign. Prodigious power numbers, and he cut his strikeout rate. And now 2-1. The Cubs bullpen with some action. Keegan Thompson up and throwing for manager Craig Counsell. Miller getting cranked up as well. Smoked on the ground a second. Throws to first. Now one gone in the top of the sixth.
Now back, the designated hitter, Marcell Ozuna.
Marcell Ozuna now at the plate. The 1-1. Foul ball there. Base is empty, one away, and we're the top half of the sixth. Popped up under this one. Out number two.
Now back, the center fielder, Michael.
So now to the plate for Atlanta, Michael Harris. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. So how much does his speed factor into his ability to go get it?
It's heartbreaking for the hitter because off the bat, he thinks this ball is going to get down because of that speed and the ability to make up so much.
Thompson makes the catch, and that's the third out. Nothing doing here this half. Heart of the order, 3-4-5 coming up. It's the Braves 1 and the Cubs nothing. Back here at Wrigley Field, and up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. And a pitch. Well, with the shift on, hits right into it. In plenty of time to first, one away, bottom of the sixth.
He's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
So up now for Chicago, Christopher Morel. Home team down a run here in the bottom of the sixth. The next offering misses. Two balls, two strikes. Ripped to short. Throw on to Olsen. And that quickly, two away.
The left is number eight. Ian.
And half up to hit.
No.
Up and in, and it's 2-1. Allen catches the corner for a strike. And a pitch. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And Acuna able to make the grab. That is the inning. Nothing happening there for the Cubs. And it remains 1-0. Back here at the friendly confines. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Travis Dardo. The 1-2. Swung on, belted. Half going back. And it finds the basket and gone. It just got out of here. And they add to their lead. It's 2-0.
Low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Here's Jared Kelnick. And the righty deals. And it goes just foul.
Oh, just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Here's a 1-2. Swings, throw it in, that's a strikeout.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there. And I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in. Kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to where you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it. And not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
Swing and a foul back, that's out of play. Righty to the plate. Bounced up the middle. And that chance handled. Over to first. Out. Two away now.
The right fielder, number 13. Ronald.
Here's Acuna now. Two down, bases empty, but one run across here in the top half of inning number 7.
That's
next offering is downstairs. That one hit to right. As this one sized up. And that'll do it. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now a 2-0 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th. Dylan Lee.
These are the now spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Leading off.
So up now for Chicago, Michael Bush.
The first baseman, Michael Bush.
Next pitch downstairs, 2-1. Movement in the bullpen, Joe Jimenez. The veteran right-hander appears to be loosening up. Minter getting loose as well. That's through there for a strike.
It's been tough for the offense so far, but you can't get frustrated. You got to find a way to shake it off, go up there, and relax. That's the only way you're going to be able to put runs up on the board.
2-2 now.
Full count.
And there's ball four.
Take your bank.
That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with the free pass.
The second baseman.
Now it's the second baseman, Nick Madrigal.
Now this team is definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame. With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Off the mark there. The count now 2-2. With the tying run at the plate, here at the bottom of the seventh. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Tying run at the plate. And a swing and a miss. And that's the first out.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count off at 2 balls and 2 strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Here's Mike Tauchman. The tying run at the plate. This one kicks away a little as he can't squeeze it. And he'll move up to second, no problem. Should be a pass ball, and that takes away the double play.
An unfortunate pass ball right there. One he's not going to be happy about behind the plate. And with the runner advancing to second, that double play is off the table right now. So we'll see if that comes back to bite him.
Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow down. Two strikes you're looking to protect, and halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. I'll tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
The new pitcher in the game, Joe Jimenez.
Pretty big spot he's coming into, trying to strand that runner at second base. So he's going to need to make some quality pitches. He does have first open if he needs to use it.
Miguel Amaya, the next Cub to hit. Check swing, now a look down to first. And he went around. Just enough that time. Bush stands at second with two gone. Next offering way off the plate.
His fans, they are ready to cheer about something.
Over. Cubs leave one and they're down 2-0. We're at the top of the eighth, digging in, Ozzie Albies.
Ozzie Albies.
Kicks and fires. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Here comes a pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2. And here it comes. In the air, foul off first. And Albies is retired. And there's one down.
Now got it. Third base, Austin Riley.
So digging in, Austin Riley. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. the pitch. And another ball. And they'll do it again. One down, base is empty. Out towards left center. Bellinger makes the grab. Two outs, base is empty. Here is Matt Olson. Ball to strike. Ripped on the ground to second. Tosses to first. That's the third out. Down in order go the Braves as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. On to the bottom of the eighth. And the batter will be the shortstop. Nico Horner.
Nico Horner.
Kicks and deals. Trying to bunt his way on. Save!
He's in there. He's safe.
Maybe a little small ball is exactly what the doctor ordered to rev up this offense, and they've been pretty quiet all game, so maybe this wakes them up a bit and helps them get on the board.
And next for the Cubs, Seiya Suzuki.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Ground ball up the middle. One at second. And that's two.
Well, the shortstop makes the decision, commits to it, touches second himself, and then a strong throw across the diamond to get that second out. Really nice job.
Cody Bellinger, the next Cub to hit. Two down, nobody on. And that one hammered. Could be extra bases. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
Two hits for him in this one, both for extra bases. Got to feel good about that. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Here's the third baseman, Christopher Morel. And that one missing low. Tying run at the plate. Fastball for a strike. Full count now.
Cold night like tonight. Last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end. Trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front. So off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Then on second, two down. Got him looking, and he did not like the call. One left for the Cubs. They trail things here 2-0. Here at Wrigley Field, new inning getting started. So here's the Braves' designated hitter, Marcell Ozuna. And another ball. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. and the leadoff man aboard.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's gonna find some holes.
Michael Harris, next up. Runner on the go. Right back to him on the mound. To first, no chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
Now batter, the catcher, Travis.
And here's the catcher, Travis Dardo. The 3-1. Foul ball.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
At the belt and fires. Ripped to third and caught. Right behind the runner. They've got it doubled off. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth, Raisel Iglesias.
And I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
I think he might have gotten away with one right there. That was a very hittable pitch right over the heart of the plate. And I know that batter is kicking himself right now. Would like to get that pitch again. Just pulled the string on it, and the deception gets him the K.
He's two outs away. And up next for Chicago, Michael Busch. One down, base is empty. That misses the zone. Now 2-2.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Two two down. Gets a piece and stays alive. Base is empty, one away. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. Swing and a base hit.
The batter, number one, second baseman.
It's not often someone hits a baseball this hard. It's worthy of a StatCast treatment, singing.
Well, I was anxious to see what that exit velo would be, and wow, 116 miles per hour. StatCast absolutely lives for these moments. You know, it's so cool to get that kind of data back almost instantly.
And now here is Nick Madrigal. Tying run at the plate. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Another 1-2. Good job to fight that one off. The 1-2.
Ball two. Two balls, two strikes.
Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. And the pitch. Now he breaks his bat. Reaching for it and brings it in.
The bat. The white field. Mark.
So it's their last chance in this one. And now the right fielder, Mike Tauchman. Two outs. Just missed.
No.
Right-handed reliever. And that drops in for a strike. Iglesias is just one strike away. Swing and a drive deep right field. That one's carrying. It bangs off the wall. Rounds third, headed for the plate. He scores, and it's a one-run game.
Well, back within one as he brings home the run. He hit that ball really well to deep right field right there. Got a pitch to drive and just stayed through it nicely. Didn't quite have the trajectory to clear the fence, but you're always happy with an extra base hit.
A.J. Minter gets the ball now.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Looks like we've got a substitution at second. On a pinch run, Pete Crow Armstrong. Here's the catcher to hit, Miguel Amaya. So the tying run at second. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that ends the ball game. The tying run left stranded at second.
Well, a four-pitch save. He was just starting to get comfortable out there after throwing a lot of pitches in the bullpen in this one. But a nice job of attacking the hitters, being very efficient. And this is what you want to do. You want to come in and you want to close things out as quickly as possible.
And your final score here today, 2-1. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
The final line score for our ballgame tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, two runs, nine hits, no errors. They left seven runners.